In 2 weeks, of course, we will come to you live on the main event during the pregame show at 6:05 Eastern Time on Sunday, May 21st, right before that. And, of course, one of the matches will be for the World Television title. Arn Anderson, who is out from underneath the guidance of Colonel Ron Parker. Now a man on his own. He's talking about Parker wanting to spend more time focusing on Ming. Arn's allowed to do that. And Anderson, of course, will face Alex Wright, the World Television champ. And, of course, will be in ringside with Flair and Vader against Hogan and Savage with Renegade in ringside. And it was wild, as we saw last week here, Breen.
And in his match with Alex Wright, it'll be 30 minutes for him to defend that title, not his usual 10 minutes. So Alex Wright has an extra 20 minutes to try to gain that television championship, which I think is totally unfair.
Eddie Jackie, the opponent for Arn Anderson, the World Television Champion. And, of course, being the World Television Champ, if Eddie Jackie should win here...
Eddie who?
Jackie.
That is his Jackie he's handed to him.
No, it's his jacket.
No, he's going to turn things around on
Yeah,
me.
Boy, sure. You're not kidding. Okay, Eddie Jackett set to go now from the neutral position.
Then he handed the girls Jackie.
I said Eddie Jackett.
Never mind. You're going to drive me nuts.
Speaking of nuts, we'll be taking a close look at Ric Flair and what has happened to him and his career from the retirement to the reinstatement. That'll be a little bit later on in this telecast. Butcher and Randy Savage in a first-round match for the U.S. title tournament.
I gotta go with Savage on that one. Butcher's head isn't on straight now.
Driving the knee into the head.
He's a man without a country, without a name, without a friend, and Savage is focused.
And you mentioned how explosive it was at the top of the program during our opening. You said that you saw Hogan, that Hogan was in the building.
Hiding.
We do understand the Nature Boy Ric Flair is here as well this week. Now you know how wild it got last week.
Exactly. Oh, this is going to be fun. You got seatbelts on that chair? You better put them on if you do. Arn Anderson's here. And, you know, usually where Hogan is, Savage isn't far behind.
Yep. Savage, of course, and Butcher in the main event later on. Hogan is here. I believe Vader is also in the area. And the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Something could happen right here during this title matchup.
Something's happened to Charlie Coates here.
Eddie Jackie. Reversal of a chin lock now.
You know, Alex Wright's watching this. He's doing his homework. But it won't help, Mr. Wright. It's not a report card. You're going to come up absent.
The referee checking in now as Arn Anderson pulls up. Puts that knee right in the small of the back on Eddie Jackie.
He's not going to beat you with that hole, but he's going to make you feel it.
Now he's going to work you down. You're right. Now the bootlaces. That's an old Anderson family trademark. Breaking the eyes of the bootlaces.
Should make bootlaces if they don't want them used. Should be nice, sharp zippers.
Well, that's a good thought, Breen. Arn Anderson.
Bob Wire. Tie your shoes up with Bob Wire.
Stop it, would you? DDT!
It's over.
On Eddie Jackie. One, two, three. Anderson decisively gets a win.
He's not quick. He's sudden.
Double A Arn Anderson gets a win here on WCW Saturday night. And nothing happened there. But as we said, Hogan and Cheer, Vader, Flair, they're all around. Anything could happen later on in this telecast. So stay with us, fans.
I'll guarantee you one thing. Anytime Hogan's in the building or Flair's in the building, something can happen.
That's a big win for Arn Anderson, but as you know, last week Diamond Dallas went on a big shopping spree. This week, we understand, our cameras followed him as he went looking for an automobile.